flag. You got me? Okay. Verse 12. Now therefore, I pray you, swear unto me by the Lord, since I have shown you kindness, that ye will also show kindness unto my father's house, and give me a true token, and that ye will save alive my father and my mother, and my brother, and my sisters, and all that they have, and deliver our lives from death. And the men answered her, our life for yours, if ye utter not this our business. And it shall be, when the Lord hath given us the land, that we will deal kindly and truly with thee. Shall we pray this? Gracious God, our kind Heavenly Father.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, here we are once again in your house of prayer. Lord, as we come before your presence this morning, God, we always thank you. Thanking you for your tender mercy.
Yes.
All of your kindness.
Thank you, Lord.
And God, you're always.
Yeah.
How's everybody doing this morning? Yeah. Ooh, my God. How's everybody doing this morning? Yeah. God is doing a great thing in here this baptized week. Y'all ought to be able to see you and God some praise this morning. Praise the Lord. Come on, let's give God some praise this morning. God is doing it. Why you say that? Come on, put your hands together.
God before.
Kind God, we pray that you would touch this moment when we are together. Father, we want to hear a word from you.
Yes, Lord. Please, Lord.
God, I know what you're doing, and Father, you know what your people need, so move upon this breath of God, those of life of you, that we love as you would love and do as you need to. We pray, God, a blessing upon those that are around me. We pray for our brother and our sister, whatever they're going through, bring them out on top and bring them out on top.
That's right.
And we bless you for it now in the strong name of Jesus. And let the glad heart say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Would you grab those Bibles with me, beloved? We thank God for our combined choir this morning.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Thank you, Lord.
Thank God for them. You know, it's not easy standing up in front of people. And so, any support we can give to anybody standing up in front of us, we ought to be more than willing to do. Joshua chapter 2 is where we are today. And in the month of May, we have been in the series entitled, Lord, Grant Me Courage.
Yes.
Lord, grant me courage.
Thank you, Lord. Grant it.
Thank you. And I guess we'll pull down the tent today in Joshua chapter 2. Joshua chapter 2. Going to go to verse 12, Joshua chapter 2. Joshua chapter 2, starting in verse 12. Now we read the King James Version of the Bible, if you don't mind today. And then you find the words recorded very similar to these. Now therefore I pray you, swear unto me by the Lord, since I have shown you this kindness, that you will also show kindness unto my father's house and give me a true token, and that you will save alive my father and my mother and my brother and my sisters and all that they have, and deliver our lives from death. And the men answered her, our life for yours, if ye utter not this business. And it shall be, when the Lord hath given us the land, we will deal kindly and truly with thee. You may be seated in the presence of God. I want to tap the track for just for a few moments today. I pray with your prayers and with God's power. I want to talk about the anatomy of a survivor. The anatomy of a survivor. Usher, thank you for your ministry. We see. It was the naturalist Charles Darwin in the year 1859 who wrote a book that has served as the undergirding of all biology. That if you went to anyone's school or was a student in anybody's class of biology, you would have heard somewhere in the matriculation of that course about Darwin and his theory of evolution. His theory was based and was argued in his book, The Origin of Species, where he writes that all organisms are adapted to their environment. And that ultimately, the best fit organism, the one that is most adapted to its environment, is the one that survives at our differences. And this principle, as I was thinking about this message, doesn't just apply to the natural science. But I find that this often is exhibited in the lives of people in our human experiences too. If we were to look at who it is that survives, who it is that gets through what they're going through, it's oftentimes those who are best adapted to their situation that can get through what life throws at them. And I found that to be relatively interesting because what the text, what that shows us here is that one's ability to get through the situation is determined by how well you make the best of what you have.
Amen.
That you don't allow the situation to change you.
Amen.
But you learn how to adjust who you are.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord.
That if you're going to make it out of something, you've got to learn how to manipulate some situations.
All right.
You gotta learn how to make the best of what you're in order to get through what you're going through.
Amen.
And if you will agree with me there, then I think we can go now to the book of Joshua.
All right.
And that's really what I see when I read Joshua chapter 2. I see the story of a woman who knew how to make the best of what she was in,
yeah,
in order to survive what she was going through.
Uh-huh.
Let me show you what I mean. At the time of the text, Israel has already come through the wilderness.
Okay.
They're on their way to the land of promise. You know that land that's flowing with milk and honey. When I was a little kid, I really thought that's what it was going to be. And when they got into the land of promise, it was just milk everywhere. But Israel has come through the wilderness, and now God is going to take them to the land of promise. He's taking them to a place where they have houses they did not build. Here they are on their way into what God had for them. But after being in slavery, after being oppressed and mistreated at the hands of Pharaoh, and having to be slaves after 400 years, their story is, we're about to get out of here.
Yeah. Amen.
So now they're on their way there and on their way to the land of promise. And here's what happens physically, that they go toward the promised land only to realize there are people in the land.
Yep.
But you understand that your blessing is never problem-free.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
And so here they are having to go where God wants them to be. Here they are going to receive what God has for them, but they run into some enemies on the way. They run into some roadblocks and some obstacles. The Bible says very clearly that they not have to come up with a strategy. But God's going to tell them, listen, if you go in there, you go do what you do, if you follow me, I'll give you the last. I'm going to give you whatever it is that I promise you. Everything that I ordained in your life, I'm going to give it to you. So here, they get you. When they get to the building, they get you. And realize that they've got to go to this place called Jericho. Now they want to set spies to the Jericho and they need to see what they're up against. And if I'm going to fight, I need to know what I'm fighting. Jericho. Get to Jericho on the Bible says something very interesting. And here Joshua has brought into Jericho and sent the spies into Jericho. And up here we find the 52-40 years of Joshua chapter. Because here in Joshua chapter 2, when the spies are sent into Jericho, the spies rise up in the house of Rahab the prostitute.
Yes, sir.
Now, we can argue why they went to the prostitute house all the time. They didn't go to the market. They didn't go to the mall. They went to the prostitute house. And I better say for a reason. And scholars all the time try to dress this up. They always want to say, oh no, she wasn't a prophet, she was an innkeeper. No, she was just, you know, a woman who was able to host and entertain people. But the text says very clearly she was a prostitute.
Amen.
And I want you to sit with that for a moment. I want to leave that in your lap for a moment. I want you to hear from me that the hero of the story is not the spies on you. But the hero of the story is the woman that's the prostitute.
Amen.
And I want to leave that in your lap for a moment. Because many times, y'all, we don't like sitting with the truth of the text. Because we here are uncomfortable hearing that God uses a woman who decides to use her body the way she wants to and makes her the hero of the story. We don't like to hear that.
No, we don't. No.
I know. And the reason is because we are so quick to assign moral judgment.
Oh, yeah. Amen.
You better hear what I'm going to tell you. That's really what the issue is. The reason why it's uncomfortable is because we like to ascribe judgment to folks based off of what we hear about them.
Right.
Without knowing what the true story is the whole world.
Right.
We talk about what we are to do. See, the problem here is that we oftentimes like to ascribe what we think about folks based off of what we hear without knowing the whole story. That a woman who won't hold it is the hero in the text.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because that shoots a whole hole in what it is that we like to talk about.
Come on, preacher.
Because you know we like those messages where the good and the upright get what your God wants in life.
That's right.
You better hear me. We like those messages where if you live right, heaven belongs to you.
Yeah.
We like those times where I'm blessed because I pray when walking the floor in the midnight hour, and I turned my plate over here, and God made something for me. But I want to tell you, sometimes life ain't that easy.
Amen.
You can put it in your breath. But the truth is that some of the blessings in your life became not because of where you were, but sometimes it's because God was just good to you.
Hallelujah.
And the truth was, but when you read about about Rahab in the New Testament, they always couple her name and the fact she was a harlot. You study it on your own and see what I'm talking about.
Right.
Every time they talk about Rahab, even in the New Testament, they always couple the fact that she was a harlot.
Yeah.
They forget the good she said.
That's right.
They forget the good she did.
Yeah.
And all they worried about was what they thought was wrong with her.
Yeah.
Lord, you better hear me. You see where I'm going already. Because
yeah.
See, what I'm trying to tell you is that many times in this life,
yeah.
You never will survive if you always worry about what people say. A corner, and they will try to move you when in reality, this is all doing right
here. Amen. Amen.
Yeah, y'all. And I'm going to tell you something. She was very selective in how she said that because she realized that the people that were coming there were not coming there for her.
That's right.
They didn't come to check on Rahab.
Right.
They weren't coming trying to see if she needed anything. They were coming to be nosy.
That's right.
Yeah.
And you have my permission. When you got those folk in your life that really ain't in your life for you.
Come on, preacher.
Come on, people.
Come on, preacher.
That when they show up at your doorstep, want to stick their nose in your business, look. Rahab knew how to read the room she was in.
Amen.
to tell you something. You will never survive if you don't know how to read who you are around. Come on here. And a lot of times people look down on that, but can I show you something in the scripture? Paul said, I've become all things.
Yes, sir.
To all men.
That's right.
That by all means I can save some. Right. He said, to the weak I'll be weak. That's to the Romans I'll be a Roman. I can fit in with anybody. Guess what? Because I know how to move and to be what I need to be for whatever power I'm around.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And maybe, just maybe, you would get ahead a little bit more in your life if you stop being so stuck up on who you think you are.
Come on, preacher.
Sometimes you need to let down your guard and laugh. Sometimes you need to let down your guard and just be human. I don't got a title. I know you're thinking so-and-so and trying to be so-and-so. But can you just be human for me? You got to be flexible.
There you go.
Tired of church folk that's so uptight and snooty, you can't even crack a joke around. Be flexible. Nobody, can I tell y'all something? Nobody wanna come to a church where everybody's uptight and mean face and ugly acting. Don't wanna come somewhere where there's a good time. You got to be flexible.
Yes.
There you go. All right, I'm on three. Let's not hold it too long. Here it is. You also have to, if you're going to survive, you have to have faith.
Amen.
You got to have faith. Didn't somebody say have faith? You got to have faith. Because the text makes it very clear. Here it is. I'm a Bible preacher. But real quick. The text says, the men make this oath to Rahab. And Rahab says, okay, cool. Let me tell you how you get out of here and do your thing. Here it is. She said, but when y'all take the city, you better look out for me.
Amen.
Hold it. She said, because look here, I am not going to be kind to you. And then for nothing.
That's
right. I wish I had some real people like that. I ain't going to be as good to you just for no reason.
That's right.
Two of y'all jokers came in my house. You think I don't let you out of here for nothing, boy?
Oh, no.
That's for real, man.
It's gonna be pay up time.
You don't understand how powerful that is.
No, for real.
You don't understand how powerful that is. Because in Deuteronomy, God told them, whatever you do, don't you make an agreement with a Canaanite woman. You read your Bible.
Yes, sir.
The Bible said if you go in Deuteronomy chapter 20, when you go into the land, kill everybody.
That's right.
Don't leave nobody. Here it is. And here, Rahab, somehow or other, got a vow out of these two men.
Yes, sir.
She got a vow. said, I want my mama, I want my daddy, I want my brothers, I want my, matter of fact, everything they got that's connected to them, I want it to be alive.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And they said, okay. How will you know? They said, hang this red thread out your window. And when we come through, we're going to look for the scarlet thread. And everything that's in there, we're going to keep alive. Watch now. And you can't read that without hearing about the passing. You can't hear about that without thinking about how it is so many years ago that when the death angel was passing through Egypt, he said, put blood on the door.
Right.
Yeah, when you saw the blood, they kept on going on. And here Rahab, even though she was not born an Israelite, she's protected by the string because of her religion. Realize Rahab was supposed to be killed.
That's right.
In fact, them to kill Rahab.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But because of her decision to show kindness,
that's right.
The Bible says she went from a death warrant to deliverance.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Yeah, yeah. Because here it is, y'all. The text shows us very plainly. When you move with kindness,
come on, preacher.
Kindness can change your soul. And I knew I only many claps right there because some of us ain't kind.
Come on, preacher.
Some of us ain't nice people. God help me. Some of us are not really good people to be around. You better
you
So you want to survive?
Yes, word.
Okay. Real easy. Keep folk out your business. You be flexible.
Amen.
And you have faith.
That's right. That's right.
And if you hang on,
come on, preacher.
Long enough.
Long enough.
God will.
Yes, he will.
Take care of him.
Yes, he will.
All right. Impossible show.
I'll be all right.
I want to open the door. for the Lord Jesus Christ. Is there one today? You want to give your life to God? Join the church? That's you. Why don't you come? Is there one today? Oh, come. Is there one? Let's pray, would you? Gracious God, we bless you for this moment. We honor you for all that you are. We pray, God, that nothing be misunderstood. But God, we pray that you would hear and allow this word to take refuge in our hearts.
Yes.
That we may have the strength to survive what life
is. Thank you, Lord.
We bless you for the miracle that you made us to be.
Yes.
Help us to be faithful, God. Help us to be flexible. God, help us, Lord, to be mindful of who we allow into our affairs. Because God, we want to make sure that we do what you want us to do.
Yes.
We bless you for this privilege, bless you for this time.
Yes.
And for these things, oh God, we give you thanks and praise.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
And every glad heart said amen.
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 Amen. Hallelujah.
Give God the glory, God the praise. You may be seated in God's presence.
Yes.
Amen. Listen. One thing, we know that this is Memorial Day weekend, and at this time, we're going to ask Deacon King to come forward for the Memorial Day recognition at this time. After that, we will deal with our certificates with our young people who were baptized today. Bless God.
Amen.
Amen. And then we will do our offering, and we will bid you adieu. Amen.
See what we have.
Oh, yeah.
So he is the top gunner. He's the top
gunner.
And I feel so good about
this. Change
him. You know, he get paid so well, and then not arrogant. Brother Gerard, all of them, I see him in the gym. The only time I don't recognize him when he got his hat turned back. stand here today and let you address this conversation, this congregation, with what? And I'll say this, my little experience, Thursday, when my wife and my two sisters was coming from my sister's funeral, and why did we stop at the lake? Long story short, we got ready to leave, and there was a gentleman holding the door. I said, ladies, come on out. The man got to go. He said, no. He stood and held the door until we got in the car. Then he came back over to the car. He said, we just got a black top general in the United States that runs the military. And I didn't want to, you know, and I thank God for a sound mind and a written mind that can remember everything. I just thank the Lord for a sound mind. Because I can take pills for eight. But thank God my mind is intact. So the gentleman came back over to the car, and I wanted to say to him that Holy Mile was the first black. But I didn't do it. I talked about it when we met whom. But what we had was history. He thought it was history. You got a new black joint chief of staff that reports to our Secretary of Defense, which is
yeah.
Black.
Yeah.
And Sergeant Webb reminds me of Austin. What's the name of the fifth Secretary? Austin.
Lloyd
Austin. He reminds me so much. So the history of, you got the man in uniform that's in charge of all the military, and then you got his boss that's in charge of everything.
That's right.
And there's a black reporting to a black. That's where the history came.
That's right.
Amen.
Got you.
So you will, Sergeant Webb, please come share with us some blessings. Did I know you so much?
Oh, Lord, put this hands together. Thank God. Thank God. We thank God for all our ministry, all our servicemen and women who who do what it takes to keep us free. And we thank God for that. Thank you so much, sir, for your service. And to, matter of fact, all of our veterans who are here and serve, that's connected to us here tonight. We want to just let you know that we love you and we pray God for you and thankful. Thankful, thankful, thankful. Because everybody couldn't do it, but we're glad you did.
Amen.
Thank you, Deacon, for that. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Thank you. At this time, we are going to call up our three baptism. Our new members. my offering here real quick, because we got to do that. It's nice to be here, but we need your gifts too. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Let's take those gifts, Bible says the Lord loves the children, which means we ought to be excited to give at the work of the Lord.
Amen.
We understand that we can give unto God, He gives back to us good measure. Press down, take it away. Run it over. Yes, the Bible speaks to that. So we pray to God. Thank God for all those in our virtual spaces. Thank God for those who give through our Givelify app. It is a new day. If you don't have the type that you can put in an envelope, you can do it on your phone. Look at the goodness of the Lord.
Amen.
All right. I'm telling you, I went to the store the other day and didn't have my wallet left at the house and used my phone to pay for what I need.
Amen.
Look at the goodness of God. Bless Jesus. You said somebody's not good. I'm really grown for a bit, man.
Stay in your lane. Acknowledge.
Here you go. Let those gifts listen. God, thank you for the gift. God, thank you for the giver. We thank you, Lord, for the privilege to give in your name. We pray that as we give unto you, that nothing go lack in our lives, but God, find a way to bless us. God, we seek increase over for in favor over his gifts in Jesus' name. All prayers are right with us. I will bless you for it now. In your name we pray. And all of God's people said amen.
Amen.
Amen. Listen, all who's going to come at this time, they're going to take up your gifts. Listen, I would make a couple of announcements while they're coming. Again, we want to thank God for those three new members we have tonight.
Amen.
Bless God. Bless God. Bless God. Bless God. That means, church, you're not dying.
Yes.
Amen. You're not dying. You're still growing. Amen. So listen, also, Lord, I would like to mention, let's continue to pray for those that are going through sickness and disease, those that are bereaved in this hour. Listen, we understand that it's just good to pray one for the other. So let's continue to pray one for the other. Continue, let's keep the Brown family in prayer as we lay Brother Brown to rest. On Monday, let's pray for that family. Also, let's pray for the King family as well. I think King and Pastor, his sister. And just all of those who have lost loved ones along the way. Let's pray. Let's pray for them. We also ask that you will continue to join us on Wednesday evenings for our prayer and Bible study. We are continuing to grow together as we love the word of the Lord. Continue to let's be together in that exploit as well. Continue just to be good people one to the other. Let's just show kindness to one another.
Amen.
Okay, that goes a long way, so let's just do that. All right, I think that's all I needed to say. Would you stand with me? Youth rehearsal after church is today. So young people, make your way to the choir stand to do that. Do your due diligence here for next Sunday. Amen. Our graduates, we will be doing that on next Sunday.
Amen.
First Sunday in June. Have your graduates here. Amen. With all your stuff. Okay? Bring them. Come. Tell them. Let's come. Let's celebrate what our young people have
done.
Because it takes a whole village to raise a child.
Yes,
amen.
Amen.
All right, y'all. Let's look to the Lord. God, we thank you, and everywhere we give you praise, thank you for this moment, thank you for your spirit, thank you for your visitation. Go with us and stand by us, watch over us, and keep us in prayer.
Yeah.
And we speak it now, for now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the superintendent of the Holy Spirit rest over the body henceforth, now and forever, and every glad heart said amen.
Amen.
And y'all bless me, y'all be safe, have a good night.
Hallelujah. All right, y'all.
All right, Danny.
Take care.
Okay, check
it.
All right.
Sir.